Welcome to Everything Computerized. I am CA and in this video I'll be going to show you how to use the MySQL Command Line Client. So watch this video till end and let's get started. This video is actually not a part of the SQL tutorial, but I had uploaded this video just to show you how to use the MySQL Command Line Client. In my videos, you might have noticed that the MySQL Command Line Client is something like this. But when you first time install the MySQL, the Command Line Client appears something like this. So I want to tell you guys that these two are exactly the same softwares and you don't have to worry about it. Previously, I had uploaded a video on how to install MySQL for running the SQL queries. If you have not seen that video, you can go to the description. I have given the link of that video there. After the successful installation of the MySQL on your computer, you could see these all applications are installed on your PC. Here you can see there are two applications. One is named MySQL 8.0 Command Line Client. And another is named as MySQL 8.0 Command Line Client Unicode. So you guys might be wondering which application you have to use. So I want to tell you that you have to use the MySQL 8.0 Command Line Client only. The other one, that is the Unicode, is something different. Unicode means a specific text format in Windows or any other operating system. So the commands written on this version of Command Line Client is somewhat different from the basic way of SQL. So for using this version, you have to make some changes on your computer which might create some problems in other applications. So you just have to ignore this and just go ahead with the default version, that is the MySQL 8.0 Command Line Client. Open this app and the first glimpse of the application will be something like this. In the videos which I have uploaded till now, you have seen an interface like this. Don't worry, I'll show you how to change the interface from this to this. So when the first time you open the Command Line Client, it would appear something like this. It is asking for a password. Remember when you were installing MySQL, you were asked to set up a password. So you have to enter the same password which you had set up that time. Enter the same password. And you could see the MySQL server is running now. It might sometimes happen that when you enter a password, the MySQL window closes. So there's nothing to worry about it. It happens when you enter a wrong password. So enter the correct password, that is the password that you have set that time, and the MySQL server will start running. The window will appear something like this, and here you can type all the SQL commands you want to run. You can click on the maximize button to maximize the window for your convenience. In my videos, I was using a different type of interface. So let's see how you can switch to that layout. So for that, you have to right click on the title bar of this window. After that, you could see these all options are available. You have to click on defaults. A small pop-up window will appear on your screen. Here you can change the size of the text, the color and the background. And each and everything about your interface. To change the size and the font of the text, click on font. In this section, you can change the size of the text, and in this section, you can change the font of the text. Here is a small preview of the text, how it will appear after the changes you do to it. For changing the color of the text and the background, you have to click on colors. By default, the background is black and the color of the text is gray. Let's change the color of the text. For that, you have to click on screen text. Here are the different text colors which are available. I like black text on white background, so I will change the text color from gray to black. And for changing the background color, you have to click on screen background and then you have to select the color which you want. So I will select white. So this is how our interface will look like. For applying the changes, click on OK. And then close the current SQL window and open a new SQL window because the new changes will appear from the new window. So let's close this and open a fresh window. So you can see that the changes have been applied and the interface is like what I was using in my videos. This was about how the interface looks like. Let's see how to run SQL queries here. Let's create a table. So I have written the command to create a table named tutorial with three fields into it. Let's see if this command works or not. You can see it is creating an error. It is saying no database selected. So the first thing before running the SQL queries is to select the database in which we have to run the queries. So we can either create a new database and then use it, or we can select from the existing databases. So if you want to create a new database, you have to write the command create database, database name. This will create a new database in your SQL. If you want to see the databases which are present in your computer, you have to write the command show databases. It will give a list of all the databases which are present in your computer. From here, you can select any database in which you want to create the table. For selecting a database, you have to write the keyword use, and then after that you have to write the name of the database which you want to use. This will select that database for the further commands which you will run. If the database that you have mentioned is present, it will show a message database changed. Or if it is not present in the computer, then it will show an error, that is unknown database. A very important thing that you have to keep in your mind is that the SQL commands always end with a semicolon. And if you don't include this in your commands, then it will give an error. So this was about the MySQL command line client. I'll discuss about the other common essentials of MySQL in my upcoming videos. Please don't forget to like this video and subscribe my channel if you haven't yet. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.